Fresh from the What's New video last week, we've got MPC's 1/25th scale Pontiac GTO Super Stocker. This thing is an all kind of interesting hometown dirt track or short track style racer. Check out that cool chassis, these interesting headers that come through the center of the body. We've got some nice box art, we've got decals, pad printed tires. So let's start taking a look at everything that's in the box. One thing about the box, it says Super Stocker series, so maybe we're going to get to see more in this line of kits that we haven't seen before. First thing up on the table, a beautiful set of four pad printed Super Stocker tires. We've seen these tires in other reviews. They sand up beautifully and those white letters look awesome. Black wall, if you're not a fan of the Goodyears, you can always go smooth wall on the other side. We've got a small chrome tree, which is to be expected on a model like this. We got some valve cover, shifter, alternator, and the rear bumper. So that's right there. We've got a one-piece piece of glass. Front and back, this will go in the body nicely without any complications. And this kind of glass you can use super glue on because you just glue it in the center. And you don't have to worry about it fogging the glass or anything. They've got a beautiful updated decal sheet. We've got some fade stripes here. We've got some center stripes that make room for the hood scoops. We got some digits here. We got contingency stickers. We got a 70 license plate. We got a Lowell Sidlow name on the side. 400 cubic inch logos, 77 logos, or number 7 twice logos, whatever you choose. Number 52 logos. We got all kinds of cool stuff on there. Let's start looking at the plastic in the box. We've got some roll cage material. We've got, this box has some loose parts in it, so be careful when you're going through your parts bag. We got a nice net there, a nice chassis. We've got each side of our 400 inch V8, some cylinder heads, intake, standard air cleaner. We got a battery in this one, water pump, nice thin belt and pulley system. We've got some more bracing. We've got what looks like a dashboard, firewall. We got that nice hood, which is pre-opened. It would be in real life, I'm guessing. They'd want as much fresh air under there as they could. We've got part of the chassis, a roll cage component here. We'll see what all this is in the sub-assembly show-off. We've got some more individual parts in the box. We got part of our rear pan. We've got our chassis here with our suspension arms in the front. This is a race car, so don't expect it to look like a stock vehicle on the inside. We can do all that up in a metallic if we wish. We got part of that rear roll pan under the bumper. We've got some more chassis components, more frame component. Right so. We've got what looks like part of the front of the roll cage, maybe part of the front of the frame that goes around with the suspension arms through there. We'll see when we get it assembled. I don't like to look through the manuals a lot. I like to be just as surprised as you are when I start assembling stuff to see what it is. So let's get some more stuff out here. We've got all kinds of racing components, suspension, steering, shock absorbers, another battery, part of our very interesting header system. Looks like parts of our differential, pedals. Another set of longer shocks there. We've got more chassis and roll cage components, drive shaft. Well, these parts here, we'll figure out what all that stuff is during the build. Check out these interesting headers. They're put together, which is great. Allows me to glue them on in final assembly, but these go up and over the engine. I've only seen that in a boat. We've got our racing bucket seat, tie rod there, shocks, springs. Nice carburetor mounted on its own. Some more cylinder heads. All kinds of bonus stuff for the parts box. Got our leaf spring assembly. Looks like a quick change rear end. This is either the firewall or this goes behind the seat to protect the driver. Part of the chassis, part of the metalwork on the inside. We've got two more sets of parts here. We've got a steering wheel. Looks like parts of our wheels. Radiator assembly. Part of the interior somewhere. It's got some cool rivets. Got an indentation there. Maybe this is the tunnel that those headers go through. Looks like part of a firewall or frame. It's got some stuff I've never seen before. We got our wheel backs. wheel inserts and those nice five slot wheels. Nice looking. That is all the plastic in the kit except for the big old GTO body. Look at that thing. You can definitely tell it's cut out for a race car. Would be next to impossible to build a stock one without a lot of work. We've got riveted on body guards. We've got closed off riveted on door handle covers, all been smoothed out. We got hood pins on the trunk. So this is definitely a race car. Oh, here's where our exhaust comes out, I'm guessing. Nice big hole over there, unless it was the world's weirdest short shot. And that nice GTO front end, all assembled for you, so you don't have to align a nose to it. So that's a pretty cool looking assembly. That's everything that's in the box of the 70 GTO Super Stocker. I'm gonna get to building mine and be right back. This model ended up being more detailed than I ever expected, especially with the MPC on the box. Sometimes they have a low parts count, a little bit lower detail, easier build. This one had a lot of detail in it. I was really happy when I started building it up. I mean, check out the detail on the fuel tank here. We've got the filler nozzle, the riveted on cap, and it has a little chrome gas cap on the chrome tree that we'll be able to apply. So I'll be painting that separately. I'll be painting the drive shaft ring there and the battery. We'll get those all painted up. These shocks are not used in this kit, at least as far as I saw. So those will be painted up separately. We got those together. We got this really nice firewall. Steering assembly, I mean, look at that steering arm going all the way down with a joint on it and everything. We got the brace for it. We got our pedals in between it. We've got the master cylinder on the other side, and I will attach this later after I get it painted up. Same color as the radiator and the tunnel, and I'll prime the steering wheel and then cut it free before I paint the final colors on these parts. And we got a cool little rear view mirror that bolts onto this tunnel that will cover those headers coming through the car. So I want to get those all painted up a nice, like a sheet metal color. We got the air cleaner, two parts. I'll get this painted and then hand paint the element of the air cleaner. This body molding here, we'll use that little nub of plastic, get it painted, and if I need to touch it up, I can just touch it up with a small brush. That's how I do everything that I cut off the thing. We've got all of our parts back here, all of our covers and safety sheet metal and everything with the cool little rivet detail. We're gonna get that painted up in a bare metal color that'll contrast the chassis. We got the cool headers ready to go. I wanna do the headers and their outlet pipe in a flat white as if they were ceram coated, because I definitely think they'd be coated and likely wrapped if they're gonna run through the center of a car like that. I'm not gonna wrap them, but I will paint them as if they've been ceram coated to sort of contain the heat on the way out. The hood's all set to go. You can paint that body color, you can paint it a contrasting color, whatever you wanna do with it. I've got my ideas for it. We've got part of the chassis here. This will actually mount on the front of the body as a Nerf bar over here. So I'm gonna be painting that the same color as the chassis underneath. And then we'll be attaching that with super glue at the end of the build. We've got our driver's seat, our fire extinguisher, our radiator line, and it looks like a crossover pipe for the engine. That's what I think it is so far from the instructions. So I'll be painting all those up and then detailing them separately, but we'll get them all primed together so that I can work on them. These are some extra roll cage parts. This goes from the back of the roll cage to the firewall, so I will be painting it and attaching it later. This is underneath on the chassis here for a drive for the X braces and a drive shaft loop. So I'll be painting that separately, getting those a contrasting color to the main chassis and putting them in. Just those little bit of contrast draws attention to it. We've got our battery, belt and pulley system, and air cleaner, so we can paint all that black and get that bolted on. We've got our little tiny dashboard. I'll show you, we'll get that painted, and I'll show you how to detail these super, super faint gauges that are on there. And then we've got another piece of sheet metal work for underneath the car. So we'll be getting that painted separately. The wheel and tire package, those tires are super flexible, so I glued the wheel package together. We can get that all painted as one and then push those beautiful tires right over the top and they will go on easily. We got the 400 inch motor here with its transmission, coil, distributor. I like the chrome valve cover, so I'm gonna leave those off. We got our carburetor on there, I can get that painted. We got our water pump on the front, and we got the starter and solenoid attached on the side. Nice representation of the engine. will drop right in at any point in the build, so we can put that in there. The body itself doesn't need any work, doesn't need any cleanup. It's all ready to go. We've got a two-part drive shaft. The other half is attached to the car because this chassis can be lengthened and shortened depending on the body that's going on it. So we've got the drive shaft here. That will be painted with the headers in a flat white color for visibility if it flies off the car. The beautiful chassis work on this thing. Really nice. Now, you see we've got all the parts that come together here and hold it. One thing I did not do when I glued this front part of the roll cage on was I did not glue this to the front of the roll cage. For one, it fits in there beautifully as it is. If I wouldn't have told you that wasn't glued on, you would have had no idea. But I still have to paint my firewall separately and get it in. But I wanted to glue this front part on securely so I will be able to easily spread this out and push that firewall in and then just snap these back into place, and no one will be any the wiser, and I can get that contrasting color of the firewall inside. But the rest of the chassis I'm going to paint up in one color. You could do the differential in an all metallic or raw color, whatever you choose. That's up to you. It's your build, so you decide how you want to go about it. I also did not install the shock absorbers on the rear. They are install on large pins. They're very prominent. I will be painting those separately as well. But you can see how nice all those parts look now that it's all together. Those cover pieces will go over the back. Our fuel tank's going to go back here. We're going to be able to see a lot of it when we get it built up. So that is a nice chassis with a nice amount of detail. And looks nice. I keep saying nice, but that's exactly how it comes out. I really like it. First time building a kit like this, I can see why you guys were hungry to see this one built. I'm going to get everything into paint. Come on over and follow. Thank you.
puertorriqueña. Yo te la traigo de Coupé, de Vega Baja y de Santurce, de todas partes de Puerto Rico.
Siempre. Thank you.
I stopped here and I didn't add all the sheet metal inside the chassis yet because I want you to be able to see how it's going to go together. And I want you to be able to see all the design before we seal it all up. But that's it with the fuel tank and the battery in the back. We got our shocks in there. Check out how those headers come over the top of the engine and all the way through the firewall and out the side of the roll cage back there. That is a very unique look. I've got the dashboard just laid up there. It has the grooves here to sit on either side of that roll cage, and that's where we'll glue it in once I get all the, what I call the armor plating or the aluminum cladding in there. That'll just sit up on top. We accentuated those dash gauges with some silver pencil. Very easy to do since there are no decals. You can see inside the car now. You can see the engine mounted in with its air cleaner glued on. We can go underneath, see our drive shaft, our X bracing. I could paint the quick change rear end. It all depends on how far you want to take your model. I've got the radiator installed, the radiator line, the crossover pipe where the breathers are. That is all set, and we've got a completed car as far as that goes on that chassis. Looks very sharp. We got the body all ready to go. We did our trim, we did our metallic armoring all the way around it. We closed off our door handles. I used the same silver that I used on the hood pins for the door handles, for the headlights and the fog lights to block those off. And then I used the Molotow for the trim and the side armor. The little Nerf bars on the doors and all that stuff, just for a little contrast and whatnot. So this is, I'm going to do this as, you know, he's just getting ready to race it for the first time. I thought about banging it up, but not this one. It was so unique. And the chassis is so unique and different, I decided to leave it as a new one. And if they release more in this series, then we'll get into denting up the car and beating it up and stuff like that. So that's all set to go. Gorgeous wheel and tire package on all of these. And I love the large square mounts on the back. They make it so easy to put the final car together. They just push on. A little bit of glue will hold them on there, and they look stupendous. So I've got that. I've got to put the armor cladding on inside. So I will push that down in there and get it over the mat. I want you to be able to see the headers though before I did that. These two pieces will end up going here. Actually, they go like this. These two pieces will go under the roll cage down there. That's why I didn't glue that all the way together. This crossbar will be glued in over the top once that's in. I left the front bumper guard black. I like the look of that. Instead of chassis color, we'll glue that on to the front of the body. We've got our bumper. See how cool that chrome looks when you brush it with dull coat? Looks just like all the other accents on the body now. So it matches up, lines up, looks like the interior pieces. So that is all set to go, and that's it. Then I'll decide what decals I want to put on my version. Got the 400 cubic inch, we got the names, we got the letters, and we got some really nice stripes. And if you look at the decal, those stripes are open to fit around the openings in that cowl hood. So, I'm going to get all that stuff done. I'll be right back for the final. Another kit that you folks had said, man, I can't wait to see this thing when it comes out. It was broadcast to come out this spring, and here it is. MPC's 125th scale 1970 Pontiac GTO Super Stocker. They're doing a lot of these local modified racers, stock cars, stuff like that, and I'm really enjoying them. They're very easy builds. This is a completely unique chassis I've never seen before. I've said that numerous times in this video because it just completely is. I love these wheel and tire package. Now, I built that with that same wheel and tire package. They included about four different kits so far, I think, and I really enjoyed it. The decals laid down beautifully. You can see with just a little bit of solvent, they sucked right down to those Nerf bars on the side. This is really interesting, the way the exhaust comes through the body. I've never seen that. All that sheet metal inside, you can see it through the back glass, you can see it through the side. It's definitely interesting, and I'd love to see more kits with that body going over that chassis. So hopefully they'll have something else in the Super Stocker series that I can build up and dent up and rust up and bang up a little bit. This one being the first one that I've seen, did it nice and shiny, super easy. That Krylon candy pear color, not pearl, pear color, laid down real easy. The decals just slide down. Didn't even rip the long, thin ones on the side. Of course, you have plenty other designs if you want. You want to do that like sunburst design on the front fenders with that red stripe. You got the big black stripes. You got the 52. You got contingency decals. You got all kinds of stuff to stick on there when you want to. It sits a little bit down in the back end, but guess what? That's exactly how it sits on the box. You can see a larger gap in the front and back in the rear. It's the same way that I set up my RC cars. A little bit lower in the rear, a little bit higher in the front, gives me more push and less hook. So every time I touch the steering wheel, it doesn't hook and spin out. So that's how I would set up my race car to begin with. And I think that look is cool. You can take the hood off, take a look at the whole car with the engine, and we'll hook those, what spins around, we'll hook the holes in the hood, which are open from you, and you can see inside how cool it looks. That's why I made sure to paint the inside of the body and that very interesting header going up and through and underneath the dashboard and through the side of the car. Very unique, very interesting that they would do it like that. I'm guessing whoever designed this, if it was a real life look, that they actually enjoy bending and welding pipes. Some people love doing it, so they really enjoyed creating their own type of exhaust system. And it all lines up on the model. It's not even a problem to get it all together with that contrasting colored chassis and everything. The hood just drops right into place. If I get it to, there we go. Just falls right on, fits beautifully. We got numerous hood pin details and all other accents on the car. A very easy to build model. If this is your first glue kit, you're not gonna have any problems. Getting the body on's a little tricky because that exhaust comes out of the body. What I recommend is you get it over the nose first, then you slide it on the side. You'll have to stretch the body, but it stretches open really easy. And pop that header through the side, then snap it on the other side, push it down, and you are set to go. So, thanks for watching this review. Thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over. I will link to where you can snatch this up on the interwebs. And as always, build your models for you. Have a good time. Smile while you're enjoying your hobby. Build for you and enjoy yourself. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next review.